don't put that monolithic shit on me. They don't have to do it. It was their choice. They were committing a crime. Do you really think public knowledge about any of those things would help anyone? No, it wouldn't. Sometimes ignorance is bliss. Alright,
to be honest, I had to agree, but here's where things really went to shit. He went on.
Before there would be maybe 2 breaches a month, and then it skyrocketed up to 20, and then 50. They looked into it. Apparently, there were rumors crinkling around the deep and the dark web. A rumor about a page that held secret nobody was supposed to see. They decided to find out how easy it really was to access this place just from reading forms and shit. It took the experts about 20 minutes to find it just by solving weird fucking riddles and then following those links that would spawn from them. And then there was the final prompt. What do you seek? You have seen it.
No, I know that
there's a lot of different answers that could work. Anyways, it didn't make any sense. Everybody that was supposed to know about this was grilled. Somebody had to do doing this right. Nobody fessed up. Honestly, everybody seems genius when they said they didn't do it. They knew the consequences. After in-depth investigation, nothing was resolved, and then it hit them. Back in 2010, they had also finalized an experimental AI. I will spare you the details, but it went off the rails. Nobody could control it. As soon as they thought they could turn it into a furial trip, it just disappeared. It didn't come up back until now.
He paused after that, like he was waiting for me to connect the dots. So you think that this AI reserved and is not directing people there? I asked. He said that he doesn't think that the case. He knew it is.
It's the only feasible explanation,
he started.
But why? I don't know,
he responded. I was staring to get a hint now about why this was happening to me. Those people, they aren't after me because I saw those links. Are they? He just nodded. It's what I saw after. And you think this AI has something to do with it? Another nod. Well, what did I see? He took a second before speaking.
I couldn't tell you. There's something there I didn't even know about. All I can tell you is that there are some groups, some people out there beyond any government that are after this kind of stuff, this forbidden knowledge, and somehow they knew that you have seen it and they want to know what you know.
And they came after you as well?
I asked. Yeah, they knew we talked to you.
A wave of glitter came over me. Did I get that guy killed? However, this glitter quickly turned into false. Well, what the hell am I supposed to know? I don't know what the hell is what I saw. A dry chuckle came out of him. Well, they don't care, do they? They will jump at anything. And who do you work for? The government? I finally asked. The question had been on my mind since I got here.
Kinda,
was all he responded with. He moved up, taking out a pair of car keys.
We gotta figure this out. We gotta go.
Go where? I asked.
Vegas.
In any other situation, I would have been escalated. We went outside and he led me to an older, beat-up sedan. He said with a smile. I could tell he was just trying to lighten the mood. The drive was long and intense. We barely spoke. My brain was fried at this point, so I didn't bother asking more questions. I did remember one particular conversation we had though.
Listen, if anything happens to me, there should be a file on the BlackBerry named Consult. Everything you need to know will be there.
I remembered feeling filtered. What could happen to you? I respond.
I don't know, just in case, I guess. Don't lose that phone.
In reality, I knew there was a lot of things that could happen. I just didn't want to admit it. He woke me up when we arrived at McCran. I was confused.
You have a plane ticket. Don't need him.
He responded. He got out of the car and I followed him in. What happened next was strange. He just walked past everyone. The check-in, security, everybody. They didn't even pay attention to him. Not to me either. That's when I started to wonder who the hell this guy really was. As we walked past the various stores and restaurants set up near departments, he looked a sharp turn. I stumbled, keeping up. He walked towards an stamped door set up right between two shops. He swung it open and I followed. He walks between a band of corridors, turning every so often. Various men in suits passed us but didn't seem to acknowledge our presence. We finally got to another door. This is one request a key card. He took one out and scanned it. I didn't realize how huge this place really was until I thought about it after. We must have passed at least 15 other hallways. Anyway, the door opened up to what looked like a long flight of stairs. We tricked it down for about 5 minutes before we got to what looked like another terminal. Now, it didn't look fancy or anything, just a regular damn terminal. Surely, there's no plane taking off here, I asked. He said, I was right. That's when I noticed the train tracks.
Now, we wait.
And he sat down on a bench. Well, great, I do given up trying to piece this together in my head. So I didn't even bother asking what this place was. Let's just see what happens.